you read TechCrunch, you read the newspaper, it just sounds all amazing. And sometimes it is amazing, but most of it is gut-wrenchingly hard.
This week on Mark Cuban's Founder Focused, we're talking with Paul Kraszewski, the founder and CEO of Wrench, an AI startup in Montreal. We'll see how new tech can fit into markets beyond the intended target, and get some insight into what Paul's learned over the course of founding and selling multiple tech startups.
We're building an AI platform, so now you don't have to really know much about AI. You have an app idea, you hook into our cloud, and you stream video up, and we stream AI back to you.
As a kid growing up on a farm in Canada, Paul raised and sold pigs to earn the money to buy his first computer. And he got to brush up on his sales chops early on by convincing his brother and dad to split the cost with him.
I sold my pigs and I got $250. I asked my dad, I said, look, I put in $250, my brother put in $250, match us and let's buy a computer and I'll learn how to program. And my dad did. And I mean, that's been like a theme in my life.
Paul started his first company in 2000 and focused on developing a simulation system that could generate animated crowds of people. His goal initially was to put that tech to use in the film industry.
Computer graphics at that time, the most interesting things were in film production. We got to work on some Star Wars, Disney things, you know, lots of TV, lots of movies.
And while TV and movies were the initial target market for Paul's company, it didn't take long for other industries to find a use for his crowd generation software.
And I think it's a good lesson in pivoting. We wanted it to be real time, so we started working in video games. We worked with Midway and other companies. But where we got the biggest lift off was in military simulation and training. People started phoning us and saying, hey, can you use this to do military simulation? We said, sure, that's easy. Why? And we started getting our first contracts, and it just snowballed. So what I really learned out of all of that was, you know, you may have a technology vision, you may say that's the right market, but there might be a way bigger market somewhere else for the exact same technology. And literally, we got acquired by the largest military simulation company in the world 12 months after.
That's the thing about building software. What you're really building is a tool that people can use. And if you show enough people what that tool is capable of, someone is sure to find a use for it that you might not have considered. That was the mindset Paul had when he went to found his current company, Wrench. He didn't necessarily know who would be using his AI platform or for what specifically, but he did know that it would be useful.
We try to say, what is an interesting technology? Wouldn't that be cool if you could have the ability to scan humans in a phone? But we didn't know where the biggest market would be for that. We had some ideas. And so we first built the technology, and then we seeded out sort of little ideas, you know, in different places. When you're building software, you're building deep tech, you've got to be really, really open-minded of where the killer use case was going to be.
So, having sold two previous tech companies and founding a third growing AI company, how has Paul continued to stay motivated and find new ideas worth pursuing? Even for a technologist like Paul, who's been laser-focused on emerging tech since selling his pigs for his first computer, there's value to be found by looking in places unfamiliar to you.
I actually took a sabbatical in molecular biology. So on the one hand, it was something totally new, and I felt like a complete idiot. But on the other hand, there was all these really smart people, and it forced me to really learn a lot of things. So that helped reset my brain, if you will. You have to somehow detach, because two things. You're too caught up into your previous thing because that was your life. And also, when you sell that company, you can't do that anymore because there are lawyers for that. So so you need to find something new.
Like most things, you get better at building a company the more you do it. So now on his third startup, Paul has made it a point to implement the things that made his first two companies so successful earlier in the process. Namely, starting by building a great team.
This company is orders of magnitude better, and why? Because I realize we're a team. So I have you know, great executives, like people who understand product, engineers, fantastic engineers, and I think I would really encourage any entrepreneur who thinks they can do it on their own, they can do 10 times more with a team. And it's not always easy, right? Entrepreneurs are control freaks, especially technical ones. You have to step back. It's not about whether you could do it better. It's if you can help that person do the job, if you can enable that person, then you can do way more. That's my biggest learning out of this company, is by sort of opening up my heart and mind. I have a great team around me, and we're building something together, and it's way more satisfying and way less lonely.
Always keep an open mind about how people can use your products. Getting it in front of as many eyes as possible can sometimes open up entirely new markets. Oftentimes, tech startups are viewed as solo ventures of a single founder coding away in their room, but a company can become even greater by hiring a great team to all work on the same problem.